Hi, I'm Judy Vitale, your astrologer with ReadTheStars.com, and here are your weekly horoscopes at work for June 8th through 14th, 2015. And yay, Mercury will go direct this week, meaning we will be out of the Mercury retrograde period. My ability to speak may return, and I definitely think that the process of making these videos will improve. Let's hope. That's going to occur, by the way, on Thursday evening time on the East Coast, 6:33 p.m. And yay, you know, wave the flag, it's going to be a big celebration. The other news this week, though, is Neptune is going to go retrograde. That's going to happen on Friday, early in the morning. And when that occurs, we're going to go back and, like, really examine some of these dreams and these ideals that we've been entertaining as of late and see how well they're going to serve us. And probably even more important, I would have to say, than Mercury going direct is going to be what happens on Sunday evening when Saturn sneaks back into Scorpio. Now, if you remember, we had a big celebration when Saturn went into Sagittarius at the end of 2014. Well, now it's going retrograde, so it's going to sneak back into Scorpio. This is a time when we're going to revisit those deep feelings that we had. And if we have not resolved them, we have not worked them out, we have another opportunity over the summer. Given that the Sun and Mars are going to be together on Sunday, it's going to make it very interesting because people will be looking for revenge. Try not to be one of those people, okay? Now, day to day, Monday, we have the Sun and Jupiter in a sextile. Very beautiful. Pisces moon, very idealistic. So we're looking at all of these things in the week to come as being positive, and that's always a good way to start out the week. On Tuesday, lots of energy with Mars in a sextile to Uranus. There are a lot of sextiles, which is a very energetic kind of feeling and something that's a cooperative force during the first 3 days of the week. So use that at work and really get your nose to the grindstone and finish up those projects that you wanted to finish during Mercury retrograde. So you're going to have Mars in a sextile to Uranus on Tuesday. This is very good for technology, pushing things forward to a degree. Don't launch anything until after Mercury goes direct on Thursday evening, okay? Wednesday, we'll have more sextiles. Very nice. Mercury and Venus and the Sun and Uranus all in making sextiles to one another. Well, Mercury and Venus will and the Sun and Uranus will. And this is a very beautiful thing too. And you know, the sky's so beautiful now. When you look up and you see Jupiter and Venus together in the sky, you can do that early in the evening these days. So onward to Wednesday also, we will have the moon going into Aries at 7:14 a.m. because on Tuesday we're gonna have a void of course moon from 2:08 p.m. On Wednesday, moon goes into Aries in the morning, lots of energy. Lots of creative energy. I would say if you're writing something or giving a presentation, and if you have to do it before the station, do it on Wednesday. Thursday, moon continues in Aries, lots of energy still, and then Mercury goes direct at 6:33 p.m. And it's just going to be a lot easier after that. On the day of the station, though, anything that you haven't worked out in terms of going through the way that you express yourself, the way that you connect with others, and also taking care of your technology and your motors in your house and everything, it's going to come up. So take care of it all now. Then on Friday, the moon will go into Taurus at 10:16 a.m. Eastern Time, and by then, Neptune will have gone retrograde. That happens at 5:09 a.m. So you see, with this little blessed moment on Thursday evening where we have Mercury direct and Neptune just stationing to go retrograde, but then it goes retrograde. So it doesn't affect us quite as profoundly, or let me put it this way, as noticeably as Mercury, but it is more profound. Neptune is a more profound energy, and it has to do with our hopes, our dreams, our unconscious, those things that motivate us that we may not even be aware of. So we'll be paying more attention to those things over the next several months because Neptune stays in retrograde for quite some time. It spends a lot of its time kind of looking like it's moving backwards. On Saturday, we have a nice steady Taurus moon. If you have some plans, it's a good day for them. Up until about 6 o'clock in the evening when the moon goes void, of course, I think that everything is going to go very smoothly. Weddings and the like, very good for Saturday, I think. Okay, that's an excellent day for it. On Sunday, we will have the moon go into Gemini at 1:51 p.m. And then we have this thing with the Sun and Mars together in Gemini, creating a lot of thoughts and people remembering stuff that other people have done to them in the past and how they want to get back on them. And then Saturn goes into Scorpio and reminds us that we need to even the score. Try not to do that. Rather, try to understand other people's motivations and look for forgiveness and the other kinds of things that will allow you to just be happier and have an easier time in your life. Okay, so that's your week, and here's my week. This Wednesday from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m., I'll be at Journeys of Life, 810 Bellefonte Street in Shadyside, Pittsburgh, 412-681-8755, if you want to make sure you get a space, or you can just drop by. I kind of have office hours during that point in time, and you can make arrangements to do that. You come in and do a reading, or if you want me to prepare it, it's probably better that you call in advance and or that you call me directly for that. And you can always get in contact with me directly at Judy, J-U-D-I, at readthestars.com. Also, next Monday I'll be speaking at the Rivers Club for the Young Executives group at 12 o'clock, and we'll be talking about the signs at work. So if you know somebody who's at the Rivers Club in Pittsburgh, you can do that. And I'll be coming to New York the following weekend, June 20th. I'll be in town. So if anybody out there wants to see me, let me know, okay? Again, it's Judy, J-U-D-I, at readthestars.com.